inspiring. I'll decide when I think it's my time to leave. Yeah, cause hate won't retire me, it inspires me to be inspiring. When I'm low, I feel like I'm spiraling. Pushing forward, look, I can't ignore it. There ain't no I in team, but drop the TNA. Sometimes if I'm being honest, feels like...
All right, coming up next, a matchup to determine the baddest man on the planet. The UFC heavyweight title is on the line. Well, for a long time, he's been mentioned with the baddest men on the planet. For a long time, though, the title fight eluded him. Not anymore. Here he is, the number one heavyweight contender, finally making this walk and cracking a smile. He's waited a long time for this. He's not expecting a 25-minute war. He believes he has the power and the skills to get this thing done quickly. I guess we'll find out. No argument from me. Baddest man on the planet, UFC heavyweight champion. There he is in the flesh. What an absolute monster. What a title reign it has been. But a serious challenge in front of him here tonight. When this man became the heavyweight champion, a lot of people thought that this challenger was the one who would wrest the belt away. Now the fight is here. We'll see if we get a new champion or if this man continues one of the greatest heavyweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. The Brazilian is 24. The Brit is 46. He weighed in at 260 pounds. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas. Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 55 wins, 21 losses, and one no contest. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 260 pounds. Fighting out of Amsterdam, the Netherlands, presenting the challenger, Alistair the Reed. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 20 wins, no losses. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 206 pounds. Presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Black Mamba.
All right, this is for the UFC Championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
All right, so here we go, number one versus number two to determine the baddest man on the planet. Round one is underway of this UFC heavyweight championship fight. It could be a quick night at the office. We shall find out in short order. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
right, stacked guard here, DC. The feeder on the hips. What does that mean?
I mean he's out. The moment you get the feeder on the hips, all he's got to do now is just straight legs. He's got to kick and push, because how is the opponent going to stop him from just elevating him? This is a grown man. You let him get both feet on your hips, you push away, you kick. Jiu-jitsu stand-up, you know what that is, Jake.
I do.
You understand that. You know, you went to your jiu-jitsu class.
Looked like it did start a little bit. Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here.
Oh, he got him hurt bad.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Under 3 minutes remain in round one. Back to his feet.
Man, he has a great double leg. My goodness, he has a great double leg.
Huge shot, finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to find that follow-up attempt. The kill shot, which is what they call it, to go and end the fight. Left hand touch.
All right, so now we see some dirty boxing in the clinch. And DC, this has certainly been a big trademark of your success, just finding a home for those punches in these clinch situations.
This is where I live. I love fighting in the clinch and landing those strikes. There are so
many. Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
It's over. Oh, my goodness.
You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight. So on the sport's biggest stage, he comes up large. The baddest man on the planet, the UFC heavyweight champion of the world, your winner and by knockout here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 16 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Black Mamba.
So the celebration is on, and it figures to continue deep into the night for the UFC heavyweight champion, and still after the knockout victory here tonight. And given all this man has accomplished, I think you can still argue that tonight is the crowning achievement of his mixed martial arts career. Knocks out the number one contender with style points to retain his heavyweight title. Congratulations to champion, coach, team, family on the big result here tonight.
On office leave, planted seeds into blossom trees, wiping smiles off of faces. Yeah, my aim is so dangerous. Goodness gracious me, name so pepper, I bun your mouth if you speak so foul on me. I beg man, step up, I run man down if you try to get loud on me. Found a youth, I live forever. You know about my alchemies. But you don't want pressure, no, they don't want that pressure. Well, there's no cap in me, my head get wet first. I ain't done a dead verse, rather me dead first. I drop down head first, my bro got something to check if your man them's let work. Born in a network, more focus all on my net worth than the diamonds all on your net worth. You wear jewels that you can't protect. Who's that's yours, now that's our protect. Man, I'm in a building, now I'm on a real thing. Jevon come like the architect. Shots fired, no one's blasting yet. So who's the best, no one answers yet. Nobody taking a chance with Jev. I said, no one taking that chance with Jev. I mean,
should soon I'm about to rise. See me better not than twice. Diamonds make you blind. Living my life. Should soon I'm about to rise. See me better not than twice. Diamonds make you blind. Living my life.
Thank you. rushing, blood spilling, tears are pouring. It seems the well is never filled. Mentally exhausted, overworking, take another pill. Or to keep the owner of the corporation stacking billions.
These corporations manipulating our daily lives. Got us exasperated, working through all our days and nights. Sacrifice your leisure time to end up at a 9-to-5 and work until you are deceased without a single moment for peace.
Never still. It just keeps rolling down the hill. Nobody tries to stop it. They'll get a copy, get you killed. You'll be a trending topic. A cog up in the wheel. A sacrifice to the cold of death being built.
Caught up in the matrix. Virtual digital minds. We don't memorize phone numbers or directions when we drive. We don't even have to go shopping to get our food and buy things. We only push a button. We don't even have to try.
Can't even lift an eye away from my phone. Talking to Instagram live just so I don't feel alone. Flooding my Twitter feed with my deepest feelings and thoughts. My page is public, but my sense of conversation is blocked. I validate myself through followers just to feel important. Instead of living in the moment, I'd much rather record it. Nobody knows my first name, but know my Snapchat handle. I'm just a millennial. You're trapped in social media standards.
Funding boardroom salaries, they pay me an exposure. No penalties when they're late paying me. No benefits seen, just leans to lead to home foreclosure. Advertisement revenue, everything that you consume. More for them, less for you. They do all the sorting. Try to figure out ways to make you feel important while they keep robbing the blind hole extortion.
In some sense, that's the power of the internet. On the other hand, that's a perfect formula for the dark side.
This is our generation's nuclear power. How we deal with this will be the stuff of history.
This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Ha! That's on point. I like that. Moving on to the next. Keep at it. Nice boxing. Yes. Nice boxing. Now, just keep building up that damage. Let me see that. Let's go. About it. There's always tomorrow. All right, some sweet science. Let's go.
Ah! Beautiful combination. I love it. Keep it up. Put the pressure on him. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Nice punch. Nice punch. You felt that one. Alright, 30 seconds left. Oh, good job. Yeah, devastating punch. Awesome job. Go. That's how we do it.
Everybody wanna be the only one. Aye. Better pay your dues, man, if you owe me some. Wow. For anybody not trying to be given none. Nah. Body the body and leave the body slum. Body in these rappers for a living. So, trying to make a milli while I'm living. Whoa. Got a couple brothers in the kitchen. Bro, them brothers ain't cooking, now they be whipping. Dough. It's crazy how my people, they were whipping. Bro. And now most of my people, they be whipping. Cars, rolling with a pole like I'm Obi-Wan. Yeah. Ain't nobody like me, I'm the only one. Ain't nobody like me, I'm the only one. Yeah. Ain't nobody like me, I'm the only one. Bro. Ain't nobody, nobody, buddy, nobody, buddy. Ain't nobody like me, I'm the only one. Nah. I can't even listen to a joker. No. I can't even listen to Jehovah. Why? I really don't know why you think I'm bluffing. When I was never old enough for poker. Everybody wanna be the only one. Yeah. Better pay your dues, man, if you owe me some. For anybody not trying to be given none. Give me none. Body the body and leave the body slump.
If I sell drugs, then I might be rich. But mom said that's how a bad man lives. And bro said that's what a gangland is. So from 16 was a mic man kid. They keep saying I'm a young black king. Okay, then where's my banquet? They said there's more fish in the sea, but leave that one, that's my man's fish.
Snap, that's an Eiffel. Hey, us beat it like Michael. Wanna know why nobody likes you? They're scared cause there's nobody like you. Crap, that's a tower. Looking for some hope for about an hour. Looking for some flour for a minute. But to build a cake, you need some power.
If I sell drugs then I might be rich, but mom said that's how a bad man lives, and bro said that's what a gangland is. So from 16 was a mic man kid. They keep saying I'm a young black king. Okay, then where's my...
All right, coming up next, a matchup to determine the baddest man on the planet. The UFC heavyweight title is on the line. One of the best heavyweights in UFC history, the man who holds the record still for the most consecutive heavyweight title defenses, the Cleveland-based firefighter Stipe Miocic, back for more tonight.
Going into our fight at UFC 226, he was universally considered the greatest heavyweight champion of all time, and that was rightfully deserved by beating Francis Ngannou, by beating Aljo Overeem, by beating Mauricio Verdum. When you beat guys like that, those honors are cast upon you and you have deserved them. Stipe Miocic is one of the greatest fighters the heavyweight division has ever seen.
So here he is making his way to the octagon for another heavyweight title defense. This has been the baddest man on the planet now for several years, and he has taken on all comers more often than not, leaving them twitching on the canvas, knockout power for days. The question is tonight, with a challenge like this, can he walk out the way he came in as the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world? Tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. Miocic is 20 years the elder. He weighed in at 240 pounds. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the Honda Center in Anaheim, California, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 25 wins, 6 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of Independence, Ohio, presenting the challenger, Stipe Miocic. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 21 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 206 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Black Mamba.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Ready.
All right, so here we go. Number one versus number two to determine the baddest man on the planet. Round one is underway of this UFC Heavyweight Championship fight. It could be a kick night at the office. We shall... Whoa! Oh, he might be out.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
A couple of chins here being tested early. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Postured up there, gain gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Fighters back to their feet here. All right, stacked guard here, DC. The feet are on the hips. What does that mean?
I mean that he's out. I mean he's out. The moment you get the feet on the hips, all he's got to do now is just straight leg. He's got to kick and push, because how is the opponent going to stop him from just elevating him? This is a grown man. You let him get both feet on your hip, you push away, you kick, jiu-jitsu stand-up. You know what that is, Jim.
I do.
You understand that. You know, you went to your jiu-jitsu classes, post the hand, switch the hips, get back to your feet, get back to fight. Right hand punch.
Getting the hands going here early. Able to check the high kick. Oh, overhand left. No good. Good. Right to the hand. Now he's hurt.
That's one of those shots. And the night that was landed right on the spot.
Oh, he might be out. Oh! Oh! Oh!
I mean, geez Louise.
He's got to start moving.
He's trying to get his feet on the hips to try to push his opponent away from him.
Come on, look at him.
That's it.
He's trying to get the finish.
That is it.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, absolutely one for the highlight reel right there. A tremendous kick to spell the end of the night for his opponent and for him, I should say. But just caught him flush, full force. Beautiful extension on the kick, and the fight was really over as soon as that one made contact. I'm not even sure he was conscious when he hit the canvas. Outstanding performance here tonight. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is calling a stop to this contest at 3:28 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Black Mamba.
So the celebration is on, and it figures to continue deep into the night for the UFC heavyweight champion, and still after the knockout victory here tonight. And given all this man has accomplished, I think you can still...